All right, welcome back to Building Dad Bod 2.0. It is bench press day on the road to 300 pound bench press. Currently 180 pounds body weight. So we're switching from reversed bands to band resistance. So with the reverse bands, the bands were helping more at the bottom, less at the top. So the idea there was just to allow myself to feel heavy weight. So I got up to 302.5 pounds for a single on that. It's time to switch to band resistance now. So obviously with the resistance, it's heavier at the top again, lighter at the chest. But the thing with banded resistance is because it's heavier at the top with the band pulling down, it multiplies the force of gravity. So the bar wants to accelerate down really fast towards you. I've trained with chains as well. I love training with chains, but bands hit totally differently than chains do. Feel different. I've had my most success training with bands, so I'm going back to training bands. When I was 236 pounds body weight as compared to the 180 I am now, I had my bench press up to my heaviest was 319 for three reps, and I trained with bands all the time at that point. So going back to bands, see what kind of success I can have. Last year when I cut from 236 down to 170, my bench press plummeted. Part of that was the fact that my range of motion increased by a good 2 inches, and I was weak as crap off my chest at that point because I had never really trained that range of motion. Obviously, my chest was a lot thicker when I was 65 pounds heavier, so had to drop the safeties two holes and start training that range of motion that I never had before. So with the bands, they're basically actively trying to suck the bar down towards your chest. So you got to fight that on the way down and then try to explode back up through it. I have the bands tension. There's still tension at the bottom, so it's adding more than the weight I'm doing at the bottom. They're not loose there. You want to keep tension all the way down to your chest. So the goal here today was to get five sets of three with 220 pounds plus band resistance. I don't know the exact total on the band resistance. I would imagine probably at the top 30 or 40 pounds per side. I'm not sure at the bottom, but I'm not 100% accurate. They're not my lightest bands, kind of a medium light band, not a really heavy band. I'm going to show you all my sets here. This is partly for my own sort of records. I want to be able to look back at my bar path. I want to look back at my speed. I want to look back at my lockout and then compare it week by week. See how I'm progressing. So hit my six sets of three. Felt like my form got tighter as I went, so I was super happy about that. Now, switching gears quick, guess my body fat percentage. I'm gonna make a video on why I think everyone should get abs at some point in their life. So I was doing some quick googling to see what body fat percentage you need to be at to see abs. I came across AthleanX and it kind of made me laugh with the one 13 to 15% said, "In this range, a guy may look pretty lean, but you just can't quite see abs yet. Muscle definition and the rest of body will also be slightly less visible." I can see my abs. I don't think I'm in the 13 to 15% range right now. Bulking, maybe 15%. 16 to 19% said no vascularity with some muscle definition may see love handles. I definitely got some love handles going on. So I think maybe in the low end of the 16 to 19% body fat range right now. Again, I'm just speculating, but I thought it was funny on their thing. They said 11 to 12% you need special lighting and oil to see abs. Not a lot of people in single digit body fat. Most people, if you're around 11 to 12%, your abs are going to be quite clear without the use of oil or special lighting. But it's neither here nor there. We'll cover that more in that video. So now what we're doing, the goal was to do 225 pounds. I got 225.5 here. Goal was to do 25 reps in as few sets as possible, trying to stick at a minimum of five reps. Didn't want to go below five reps, just trying to stay at the minimum hypertrophy range and build my work capacity here. So first set, I hit six reps. After that, I managed to grind out five reps on every set, and it was the same thing. I felt like my form got a little bit tighter every set, And that's part of why I'm doing all this right now. So many sets, so many reps is really want to hammer home my form, get this movement pattern down so it's super consistent. Thing with bench press is like leading up last year when I was going for my 300 pound bench press, rode to 1,000 pound total. In training, I hit a 295 in the bar path. I hit it really nice. It moved awesome. When I went to do it for the 1,000 pound total, I went right to 302 and my bar path felt like trash. So then I dropped down to 295, bar path felt like trash. And I finally hit 286, but it's one of those things, if your bar path is even just slightly off, you just can't move as much weight. So just gonna hammer home the repetitions. You can see as I go, like the form gets tighter and tighter. Bar path is getting more consistent. So we're just going to keep hammering the volume into the new year. And then at that point, we'll really try to up the weight at that point. So now we're doing some incline dumbbell press, and here going more for hypertrophy, coming down and just doing a big rest, a big pause, at the bottom in the stretch position. So just being really focused on the stretch. Just hit 10 reps here, which after doing all the other bench, it was okay. I was hoping to get more than 10. I got more on my next set, I got 11, and then the set after that, I got 11. But I was fatigued, and it's amazing when you do the pause at the bottom. Definitely makes it harder. I could bang out probably 20 reps if I'm just bouncing them at the bottom. But that wasn't the goal. So I got to try to put some mass on my upper chest. Still working on that. Last year I did a video on exercises to put mass on your upper chest. And a guy told me that I literally did not have a chest. Good triceps, good shoulders, but my chest was trash. So at that point I agreed with him. Like, chest has never been a great muscle for me in terms of my very tricep dominant presser. So it takes the work to get there. So I've been working hard at that. And finished off accessories, just supersetting rear delts, tricep overhead press, back and forth, as many reps as possible on those. And then finished up with side lateral raises. Same thing, just every set, as many reps as possible until I can't get a good range of motion anymore. And then finished off with some press downs. Overhead is supposed to be the best hypertrophy exercise for triceps, but we always got to make sure we're hitting them from different angles, keep things well-rounded. That's the workout. Finished off with my favorite meal, Greek yogurt, berries, granola, and protein powder. There's the macros. I always hammer the protein hard after a workout. Hammer it hard in general, but especially after workout. When I'm about to grow up to be big and strong by the time I'm 50. Thanks for watching. Have a great night.